faced with the choices of either taking medication and dying or not taking medication and dying, they came up with a solution, and that was moving. So we're about to hear from an extraordinary young man, 17-year-old Mr. Colton Turner. Come on up.
My name is Colton Turner. I'm 17 years old now, but my journey starts in 2011 when I had drowned in a Boy Scout camp lake. The bacteria from the water had triggered my Crohn's disease, and we didn't even know I had it. But one thing we've noticed with Crohn's disease is that whether you're 10 or 20 or 80, normally when you're diagnosed with Crohn's disease, you often have a trigger. And this was my trigger. Crohn's disease, for those of you who don't know, is a form of IBD that can cause inflammation in the stomach, which can cause abdominal pain, in some cases failure to absorb nutrients. I actually had severe debilitating Crohn's disease, which means my Crohn's disease was so bad that I was actually in failure to thrive, which means I wasn't growing at all, and I was 4 means behind in growth. And this also causes you to have low energy, and the diet that you are often given when you're diagnosed with Crohn's disease often is either really strange or turns your whole life upside down. So, of course, the first thing that they started doing was putting me on prescriptions before I even had a 100% diagnosis. We had to go to the Mayo Clinic up in Minnesota to determine that I 100% had Crohn's disease. The first medication that prescribed me was Azacol, which was a pill, which was no better than taking an aspirin every single day, which didn't help the problem at all. And I'm not going to go through the whole list of medications because the presentation was only 15 minutes long, and I don't think I can fit all that in. But another medication I was on was called Remicade, which is popular for people with Crohn's disease. And after a couple infusions, I had developed medically induced rheumatoid arthritis and lupus from the Remicade. Another medication I was on was called methotrexate, and I only tried it once because as soon as I took that shot, I had profuse nosebleeds that lasted 15 minutes long. And the doctors told us to get off of it immediately. Another medication called prednisone, it gave me a puffy face, usually it does to most patients. But one thing that it did was it deteriorated the bone in my heel to the point where I had to wear a boot for 3 months. And the last pharmaceutical medication I was ever on was called Humira. And I'm sure you've all seen the commercials for Humira. I was on that. It's the little pen that you stick straight into your thigh or right into your stomach. And I was on that for a little over a year. And I'm not anti-pharmaceuticals, but I'm pro-options. Humira, it didn't help with my Crohn's disease, but it gave me a little bit more energy and made me gain a little bit more weight, and I thought I was feeling good to go to the Crohn's and Colitis Foundation's Camp Oasis. And for those of you who don't know, the Camp Oasis is a camp for kids with Crohn's disease and ulcerative colitis to get together for a week-long camp to have camp activities, to go kayaking, to rock climbing, anything that you want to do, you can do that at the Camp Oasis. But one thing they didn't take into account was that Crohn's disease often, when prescribed medication, it shuts off your immune system. So if you have a camp full of kids that have no immune system, if one of them gets sick, they all get sick, and I was one of those kids that got sick. And my lymph nodes had swollen to the size of golf balls. And the doctors were freaking out because two of the side effects of Humira were tuberculosis and T-cell lymphoma. Now, T-cell lymphoma is fatal. I would not survive 6 weeks after my diagnosis. So, of course, the doctors are freaking out because they think that I have this incurable cancer. So they decided that on Friday the 13th, they would have surgery to remove the lymph node and to test on the lymph node to see if I actually had these things. Because I had 50 different doctors saying it was 50 different problems, and all the confusion just led to the surgery. Now, If you only take one thing away from me today, it should be this. Never have surgery on Friday the 13th. And here's why. 3 days after the surgery, I remember the day. I was in the bathroom, taking a shower, getting ready for the day. And my mom walks in on the phone. And she's talking to the doctor. And the doctor says, you need to come back in while the wound is still fresh. And we're asking, what are you talking about? Why do we have to come back in? We took out the wrong organ by mistake.
Oh.
It actually taken out all my salivary glands, so I don't produce saliva on this side of my mouth at all. And that plus a digestive disorder is not a very good combination. And you can't really do anything about it because you can live without them. So